Time to fight.
Hey guys, how y'all doing today? The Weirdable here, playing me some more Horizon Zero Dawn. Now, on today's gameplay, we're going to go and take down some bandits. Actually, specifically, there are three camps that we need to destroy, and we need to get rid of them. Because, you know, they've been bad people, and we don't like bad people. We've got to kill them, because obviously if you're bad, you need to be killed in this game. But yeah, anyway, follow me. This game just looks incredible. I'm just going to say that because it really does look just so good. Anyway, sorry, I'm going to say that probably a lot through this video, so bear with me. As you just saw, I just looked at the map there. We're gonna slide down here because, you know, sliding's fun, and Aloy, I think it's Aloy, does it so well. What I love about this game, can I just say straight off the bat, is, as you see here, like, I think this is an old tank. I presume this is some kind of old tank. You see them sort of dotted around. I love seeing really old kind of relics of the past, you know. It just makes you wonder, like, I still don't really know the story and what happened to cause this kind of all this destruction and sort of essentially, you know, the whole extinction of humankind, apart from a few people that got led on to sort of create these tribes of people. And, you know, obviously there's these robots left over, but I'm still wondering what the backstory is to this, and it's slowly kind of developing. And obviously there's things that you pick up throughout the world that you can kind of try and unravel the mystery behind this, behind you know, what happened. So that's kind of it's a really nice feature that I think they added in this game. It's just, I don't know what it is about something where it's not all brand new. It's just, I think it's something that is old and it's sort of falling down a bit and it has a bit of character. I think that's so much more interesting. It's like you can see in these buildings ahead of me. It's just, oh, I don't know, it just adds so much to this game. And I know that's like the whole point of this game, is set in the future and everything's, but it just looks so good. And to be honest, I think it's such a unique setting for a game. I don't know any other game that's kind of like this. I mean, I suppose you could say like Fallout and things like that, but I'd say this is a bit more sci-fi kind of, because there's definitely a lot more tech in this. It's definitely, you know, the most far-fetched story that I've heard of, you know, these kind of like robot dinosaurs walking about, but you know, it just all works so well together. Right, anyway, so as you can see here, I'm just hiding in this grass because the robots can't see me in the grass. They haven't got great sight for, you know, slow-moving objects, so if I'm slow and I'm crouched down in the grass, they can't see me. But as you see here, I've just lured this guy in, I've thrown a few rocks for him, I just stabbed him, he's dead, okay. He ain't getting back up from that. No, to be honest, the best way to deal with those guys is just do, because for some reason you can do a one-hit stealth kill, but if you don't, they are actually to be honest, it's like this with most of the kind of enemies on this game, is they're actually quite tough, but if you get into a situation where you can do a stealth kill, it's normally like a one-hit kill, so which I kind of like, because it's kind of rewarding a player for doing it stealthy. Which I like, because I really appreciate stealth games. I think they're so good, and I, to be honest, I find them very enjoyable. And I love that you can do that in this game. You can take a very stealthy approach, because, you know, I mean, it's actually, as I've said in a previous video, it's not actually the most easy game to play. It's actually quite tricky. I mean, I know the stealth element is fairly simple, like all the buttons are simple and stuff, but once you get into open fighting and people know where you are, your health goes down pretty quickly, and enemies are quite tough, taking them on, like, you know, taking them on face to face, toe to toe, you know, like trying to go against them. So it's far more sensible to try and do it stealthy and trying to take them out sort of one by one. As you can see here, that didn't go too great, but to be honest with you, because I'm sort of attacking these bandit camps with other people, or the other kind of braves, they're called braves, by the way, the other people in the tribe, they're kind of, the enemies are kind of focusing on them, so it's actually a bit easier than what it probably normally would be if I was just attacking this lot on my own. So, you know, that's nice of them to come and help me. But you actually will see in a minute that I do manage to take down one of the camps. Very sneaky, very stealthily. Stealthily a word? Not sure if it is or not, but, you know, stealthily. Yeah, but as you can see here, I'm trying to just use my old focus. That's what it's called, focus, when you like most games do. It's just a slow-mo time thing, because again, the bow and arrow, it's a really great mechanic they've got. I love the fact that, as you can see there, like the arrows actually they stay in the bodies of the bad guys, and it just has such a cool effect. it just looks really good. But the focus thing is really useful, because when you're firing the arrows, you actually have to, like, if someone's running, you actually have to kind of lead your shot a little bit. Like here, yeah, see, I got him, which is pretty good. It's actually, I made it look easier than it is, because it's actually pretty hard, because you have to lead your shot quite a lot, because the arrows, you know, they're not bullets, which I really love that they've added that effect where, you know, the arrows do have a bit of flight time, a bit of travel time to get to the target. It makes it a little bit more realistic and a little bit more skill involved with taking down some of these enemies. So we've taken down the first bandit camp, so now we need to move on and we need to get to number two. Number two, duso, dos, tre, uno, duo. We need to get to number two. I wasn't sure what I was trying to. Anyway, enough of me. I mean, look at the buildings, man. I mean, they're so cool. This is a cool thing as well. You get this ancient debris, which you can sort of truffle through and find kind of these old ancient artifacts. You saw that there was like a watch there and a mug and stuff. But you can sell those to vendors for pretty high prices, so that's worth picking up. But yeah, look how cool this looks. I mean, as I said before, it's just such an interesting thing. Like, I mean, buildings themselves are fascinating how they're put together, but they're even more interesting when they've been sort of broken down and knocked down and Mother Nature has kind of taken them back over again, and there's ivy growing all over them, and just so interesting. Like, I can imagine the people who made this had such fun designing these buildings that were all broken, because I tell you what, it's much tougher to do that, to sort of create these broken up buildings, but broken up in a way that kind of, you know, it has a story behind it. Like, you can maybe kind of try and tell, like, how they were destroyed. You know, was it a bomb? Was it a fire? Was it an earthquake? You know, which, to be honest, at the moment, I still don't know how this has all happened. So, I mean, I'm kind of assuming that maybe it was some kind of huge explosion. I mean, it looks like there's a lot of impacted areas on these buildings. I could be completely making this all up, and it could be complete BS. But you know, I think that's what happened, and you know, the machine is maybe the old story of the machines just, you know, took over. You know, we created this, well, the human race created this artificial intelligence, and it just decided one day, you know what, we don't want to take orders from you anymore. We're gonna create our own universe. Again, look at these cars. I mean, it's just, it's all in the detail, because these cars look completely burnt and rusted, if you ask me. But it's just such an interesting kind of backstory and backdrop to it all. I think it's fascinating. As you can see here, though, it's quite easy to kind of get. I was just like looking at all the buildings, and then suddenly the little dinosaur guy just walks past. I'm like, oh shit! Quickly, and that's one of the things I love about this game, is the roll. You everything is so quick. You can just there, just like snap on for place. Well, I was going to say for PlayStation, it is only on PlayStation. It's just you just tap circle and you can just roll about. It's great. There's no like stamina bar or anything. The whole thing with the stamina bar kind of goes along with the whole thing about no carry weight. I mean, yes, you can get up to a limit of how many things you can carry, and you can actually extend that by upgrading your satchel and things like that. But you know, it doesn't. There's no carry weight, so it's not up to you to decide what you. You know, when you get too heavy and stuff like that, it just tells you. So it's much quicker, and there's no. That's why I like going back to the stamina. Like, there's no stamina bar, so you don't have to worry about running out of stamina. You're just constantly in the gameplay, and you're constantly in this fast rolling about. You know, shooting people. It's really great. So now this is the second camp. Now, as you can see here, I'm just sort of targeting. I mean, I don't normally like these kind of X-ray vision views in games, but this is actually the first game which actually has a solid reason for giving you this kind of, in quotation marks, ability, because it's not really an ability. Basically, well, when you play it, I didn't want to, it's not really a spoiler. Basically, when Aloy in the story, when she was small, she fell into this kind of cave, what she thought was a cave. It was actually like an old kind of lab or something, science-y kind of place, and or bunker, I can't remember what it is, but she basically finds this sort of little earpiece. You can see just on her ear there on the right. And it's kind of like a little, it's almost like a little Bluetooth headset thing. But basically, she has that on, and then it gives her kind of almost like augmented reality type field of view and vision. So, which makes more sense than if you've played like the Hitman games and stuff like that. Like, why can he see through walls? That doesn't make sense. But on this, I'm actually like this, because it makes sense why she can sort of see. Well, she can't see through walls. It's like an augmented reality type field of view. So that kind of makes sense. But yeah. So, as you can see here, though, I'm trying to go for the more sneaky approach. The AI is okay in this game. It's not top notch, but as you saw there, that guy, the enemies seem to have this very big field of vision, so they can see bodies. Like this guy over here, he sees one of the bodies over here. He sees them from a mile away. I mean, surely his vision was obstructed by all of that. But, you know, I mean, obviously they've got a very big target radius of trying to find bodies. But what I do like is they're very... even though they can see these bodies, they can never really see you unless you directly do something in front of them, or you fire an arrow and they can see you when you're visible, when the little eye icon, you see the little eye icon above the little map sort of compassy bit, that means I'm visible at the moment. So unless they actually see me, they won't know where I am, which is great, because in so many games they'll sort of just automatically know where you are. But I really think that AI in games has come along, enemy AI has come along so far in games, where it's not just like they just instantly know where you are, which is really nice, because it means you can actually play fairly stealthily. I said that game, that word again, stealthily. Stealthy, I think, is the word I'm trying to say. another cool thing you can do, which I'm actually just about to do to this guy here. He's just minding his own business, and then bam, I just jump on him and stick a spear right through his face, because that's the type of player I am. But that's one of the cool attacks that you can kind of upgrade. I'll tell you what, the more I play this game, the more it really actually reminds me of, and this isn't, I don't think this is a bad thing or an insult to the game, but it really reminds me of the Shadow of Mordor game. Now, I don't know if anyone played that game. Comment down below if you did play that game. I loved that game. I thought it's such a good game. And I'm so pleased as well they're bringing out a new one. I think it's called... what was it called? It was called War of Mordor or something like that. I can't remember, but they released the teaser trailer fairly recently. But why it reminds me of it, nothing to do with the setting, obviously, or the character or anything like that, but just more the simplicity of the buttons and how everything works, and how everything in that game. It's kind of like, because obviously it was taken from, the combat system was taken from the Batman, like the Arkham Knight or Arkham whatever games they are. The combat system from Mordor was taken from that. Because it's very fluid, very quick, everything is just, yeah, so on point. But, you know, because it makes you feel like you're this superhero, which is the whole point of it. That made me laugh. That was the only glitch I've ever seen in this game. but it fixed itself pretty quick. It was obviously just some kind of loading, or should I say, clipping issue or something. But yeah, no, it was, the combat system is just so quick and easy, like Shadow of Mordor. Which makes, as I said before, it just creates such a fun game to play. It really does, and it kind of has mixtures. Like, people are saying it reminds them of like The Witcher and Fallout, and I really disagree with that. I think actually it reminds me of Shadow of Mordor. And did anyone on PS2 play the Jack and Daxter game? And I don't know why it reminds me of that game. It just really does. I mean, it's just something about this kind of semi-open world, but it's one of those open world games where the story itself drives you to the locations. Like, part of me really doesn't want to just go and explore. Like, I want to do the missions and find out the areas of the map as I go along. I want the story to progress, and the map will progress. I don't want to just go off and explore. And that was kind of the same with Jak and Daxter. Like, it kind of just, bits of the map opened up and all that kind of stuff. So they've done a really good job with making this open world, but not like a really boring, I'm looking at a game in particular. I'm looking at you, Phantom Pain, and Metal Gear Solid Phantom Pain. You know, that was a cool fox, by the way. Yeah, I'm looking at that game. That just was an atrocious example of when not to have an open world game. So we've skipped ahead a little bit. I've taken out some of the some of the main people in that bandit camp. And what I didn't realise is I had actually completed it, and I've killed all the bandit camps, and I now need to go and see the person to get my reward for completing the mission. When all this kind of happens, and all these Glinthawks start appearing and destroying everyone, and it all goes a bit Pete Tong from here, to be honest with you. But a good tip, if you want to take down these Glinthawks fairly easily, use your Karja Tripcaster. You'll see it all get out here, and because they're very susceptible to shock damage, and then just as quickly as you can, just get in there and do a critical hit, and then follow up with a nice big R2, and you'll finish them off pretty easily. It actually goes a bit, as I said, a bit Pete Tong here, because I tried to do the same to this guy, but what I didn't realise is, so basically I get caught off guard here because I'm not used to their attacks yet. One hit like that, and it just completely destroyed me. Look how eerie this place is. I mean, it's so, like, the fog and stuff, and the city, and the sort of darkness, and it's a really creepy place. And what I didn't realise is there was salmon in this game. Look at that guy. He's just swimming away. I mean, I shot him. That's, you know, he obviously wasn't having a great life, but it's just so cool. There's salmon in this game. It's crazy. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you didn't enjoy the video, give it a dislike. If you want to see more content, please subscribe. And yeah, look at that nice guy. It's so good, this game. Go out and buy it if you haven't bought it. Anyway, see you guys later.